In these examples, we are going to factor a greatest common factor and then factor a trinomial. So our example says to factor out the greatest common factor first if possible, then write the remaining trinomial and continue to factor if possible. So factor 2x squared minus 14x minus 36. Well, that's going to be equal to 2 multiplied by, in parentheses, x squared minus 7x minus 18, because 2 is the greatest common factor. Well, from there, we could find numbers that multiply to be negative 18, that add to be negative 7, and those are negative 9 and positive 2. Notice that that 2 is the greatest common factor is part of the answer. So example 7, we have factor x to the 5th minus x to the 4th minus 2x cubed. First, we will look for a greatest common factor. Greatest common factor is x cubed, because all of these have 3x's at least. So I'm going to write this as x cubed. I'm going to actually put my parentheses here. That will result in x cubed times x squared minus x minus 2, close parentheses. Now I want to look for values that multiply to be negative 2, but add to be negative 1. That list isn't very long. I have 1 and 2. Actually, let's make that 1 and negative 2. That way they multiply to be a negative 2, but now they also add to be negative 1. Those are the values I want, so this will become x cubed, and then I'll have two sets of parentheses. First binomial will be x plus 1, and the second binomial will be x minus 2. So that this is x cubed, parentheses, x plus 1, close parentheses, open parentheses, x minus 2.